surprising collection of ceramics was found in a small town in South China. This large collection of blue and white porcelain amazed the world. Who buried it? What are the secrets behind the sky-high auction prices? Join us and discover the allure of blue and white. This might be one of the most important museums in the world, because it possesses 19 pieces of blue and white porcelain from the 13th century Yuan Dynasty, most of which are unique. Nineteen is a very small number, but the statistics are astonishing. This porcelain was auctioned for 15,680,000 British pounds. At today's exchange rate, that's 230 million yuan, equivalent to 2 tons of gold. Over 15 million pounds was spent on this porcelain, which is only 27.5 centimeters tall and 33 centimeters wide. If the Gaowen Museum really possesses 19 pieces of Yuan-era blue and white porcelain, its value will be astonishing. Wang Liying, a researcher at Beijing Palace Museum, understands the value of Yuan Dynasty blue and white porcelain in world porcelain history. Blue and white porcelain is white porcelain decorated and glazed with a natural cobalt blue pigment. Fired at a temperature of over 1200 degrees Celsius in one pass, it takes on an alluring blue translucent pattern. That's why it's called blue and white. Because of its exquisiteness and rarity, it's extremely precious.
元青花确实是从目前来看我们公布出来的存世品数量并不很多。
How many yuan blue and white items exist in the world today? Some say about 400, while others say about 300. It's estimated that there are about 140 such items in China. The exact number is a mystery. These priceless treasures are scattered around the world and are very difficult to trace. The Topkapi Palace Museum in Turkey has the largest known collection of 40 pieces, followed by Iran's Ardabil Shrine with 32. If the Gaowen Museum has 19 pieces, its collection will be the third largest in the world. It is said that the Gaoan is a county about 50 kilometers from Nanchang, the capital of Jiangxi province. Nobody of nationwide influence lived here in ancient times, according to the historical records. It appears to be a quiet, peaceful, and very livable place. How did it come to have this large collection of yuan blue and white? What's the story behind it? Liu Jincheng, the curator of the Gaoan Museum, looks after this blue and white porcelain. Without his permission, no one can ever see it. In response to various doubts and after careful consideration, curator Liu decides to take the film crew to a highly restricted underground storehouse. He will reveal every item of the special porcelain to the public and put to rest all doubts. As the crew goes through the first door, they immediately feel the unusual atmosphere. Enclosed all year round by the dampness of South China, it's a little moist inside. If the alarms are not temporarily switched off, they would ring loudly throughout the museum every time someone entered this passageway. Before he became curator, Liu had never been in here. To enter the storehouse takes more than just Liu's permission. A deputy curator and a storekeeper must be there at the same time. Only then can they deactivate all the alarms and security devices. As the TV crew follows the staff inside, the atmosphere leaves no doubt that some priceless treasures are hidden here. The little-known blue and white are kept behind a heavy security door. These are legendary treasures. Even in Gaoan, they are unlikely to be displayed in the exhibition hall upstairs. But here they are, before the TV camera for all to see. In the dim light, the TV crew feels dazzled by such a rare collection. Even China's National Museum doesn't possess so many items of this kind. They're stored in this seemingly simple and crude, but actually highly secure basement in this small city. Is everything as it appears to be? What are the secrets behind these ancient treasures? Huang Shui Chuan, curator of the Jingdezhen Ceramics Museum and a master of arts and handicrafts, is in charge of the world's most important ceramics museum.
Jingdezhen是世界著名的瓷都，自成历史可以追溯到汉唐。Jingdezhen陶瓷馆始建于1954年，是一个专题博物馆，它以这个收藏陶瓷艺术珍品为它的主要任务。收藏已至汉唐以来，陶瓷精品有数万件。 其中有四件青花元青花瓷。
It was in Jingdezhen that Yuan Blue and White was produced. Yet only four Meiping vases made of this type of porcelain still exist there. They're regarded by the museum as its most valuable treasures, underlying their rarity.Is the Yuan Blue and White priceless simply because of its scarcity? This seems to be only one of the reasons. The most important aspect of the whole thing is that even experts don't know where the craftsmanship first originated. Where did it originate? This simple question baffles almost all the experts. Normally, there is a clear developmental process for any historical object. Yet this is not the case with Yuan Blue and White. Even after a thorough search of all historical records and careful investigations carried out in Jingdezhen, experts still cannot find a single clue. It seemed to have fallen from the sky.Its craftsmanship was already mature the moment it landed. Traditional Chinese porcelain went to two extremes in the use of color. Bright reds and yellows were favored by ordinary people because of their connotations of good luck and happiness. A cool blue hue was favored by scholars and was used in porcelain produced in the Longchuan, Ru, and Jun kilns.
我们国家的崇尚的一种色的对色彩的崇尚，早先应该是以青色为主，以青色为美。
The blue color used in blue and white porcelain.Was not a popular color with Chinese people at one time. It seems to be a rare gift bestowed by heaven. This is a unique phenomenon in the history of Chinese porcelain. Chen Wanli, a Chinese porcelain master, listed the origin of Yuan Blue and White as one of the 15 mysteries in China's porcelain history.
陈万林先生呢是咱们中国古陶瓷界的学术权威，他的论述很多，他对研究中国青瓷器的发展史当中提出了这些实物问题，都是在那个历史时期，那确实是实实在在存在的重要的问题。
Forgers have taken advantage of the mystery of Yuan Blue and White's origins.While genuine examples are hard to find, a great number of counterfeits have appeared on the market. Where did the Gaowang collection come from? How did it look to people in the 1980s?Liu Yuhe was the first curator of the Gaowang Museum. This collection was obtained through his efforts. He's a key figure and is clear about the whole process. By a twist of fate, Liu turned to the administration of cultural relics in the 1970s. At that time, he barely had any experience of archaeology. But then an opportunity came to this newcomer.
1982年10月29号下午2点半，2点半呢，我到宣政委开会，刚刚进了宣政府的门口，他是刘馆长，蒋电打来电话，来的是发现的文物，你赶快看一下。
大概当时去了15个人，步行的很近，大概你像现在这样走路过去。
Liu Wenwu also heard the rumors about the collection, yet they never doubted the authenticity of the items. Today, they are going to revisit those days when the porcelain was first discovered.
，盖在上面的，当时还没什么损坏，还很好，看起来还比较完整，但边上呢也露出了一些瓷器，知道是瓷器，但不知道它是什么朝代的，也不知道它是重要性。第一眼看清就是瓷器，其他什么没有，就是瓷器。考古本本说是，因为我的搞German文物的。
Zhong Lin, then the head of the archaeological section, was the only one in the entire museum who had received any training in archaeology. In the 1980s, it was extremely hard to find porcelain-related information. Yet a question had always lingered in Zhong's mind. What is its actual value?
每次就去看了，看了看就找资料。考古组长熊仁，吴鹏山同的一个，我一个就到考古组办公室查资料。
看了以后，翻到了，他翻到了，终于翻到了一件跟这个很相似的。
查的是大英博物馆收藏的一些原的青花瓷，铭文，压着铭文，看那个铭文没盖着的，没有盖着的。 和我们跟明白的对比，一模一样。这个造型，你听我说哈，造型、纹身啊，纹身啊，这个腿根都是一模一样。当时熊人，我们三个特别，当时熊人啊，这刘馆长看了，这可能圆的东西呢，哇，我操，我这圆的东西，因为我们当时得到圆的东西不得了。
那个青海图那个有没有照片？
对，这刘武将军。From their descriptions, it seems that these rare treasures were obtained with no effort. But many of the details are questionable. 如果 they were buried by ancient people, they would usually leave a mark on the ground or in the cellar to identify the owner. 但 there was nothing but porcelain found in the cellar. No record of the owner was found. The ownership of this porcelain posed a major problem.
流传有序，我觉得这是对鉴定各类文物都需要的这一方面的因素。Liu
knew very well. That the history of the porcelain could only be revealed once the owner had been identified. Before searching for information, they had to find a place to keep the items, but there was no proper place in Gaoan. Although Liu didn't know much about cultural relics, he was clear that if they were really from the Yuan dynasty, those having contact with them had a great responsibility. Finally, he came up with an idea.
当即我就该跑到县里去向乡里书记汇报。但我说我前几天呢，挖了一批的原的青花瓷，原的青花瓷呢是价值非常之高。他说难得钱吗？我肯定难得钱呢。嘿，他说难得多少钱？他就问我。我当时哪里摸着整呢？我说多在一千，哎，你少在一千万，多在一个亿，我话。那个熊猴子，八零年前的话，一个亿几千万来代表啊，那天文数字了。那一千万一个亿，我高往半个小时八点，我铺面上造了，我还得拿我拿的，因为搞文物工作不讲价钱的，这叫它的价钱。
Liu had no idea whether it was really worth all those millions. But he was certain about one thing. If it was fake porcelain, it would be a major archaeological blunder. Experts at the Gaoan Museum have every confidence in the authenticity of the items. In response to various doubts, they made an unprecedented decision to open the underground storehouse to high-definition TV cameras and allow a TV crew to shoot at close range and from all angles. Now, the whole world can see the porcelain's true colors in these remarkable pictures. This is a blue and white covered jar. It's 46 centimeters tall and is decorated with a design featuring two dragons and clustered peonies. It has a total of 12 layers of patterns. With a greenish glaze, it presents a grayish blue color. Small white dots are scattered on the glaze layer.The most unusual thing is that it has a lid. That makes it stand out among previously discovered blue and white porcelain. This vase has a narrow neck, wide shoulders, and a bulging midsection, which narrows as it goes down. It has 9 layers of patterns, with a peony pattern on its shoulders and midsection.The vase looks plump and smooth. This jar has a lid in the shape of a lotus leaf. The main pattern is two dragons playing with a ball, surrounded by clouds. There are leaf veins painted on the lid with crab, black carp, and catfish designs.
纯式的罐子器物，原青花罐子器物不少，但是带盖的不多。它容易分，在这个流传过程当中，它容易就是流失了，或是打破了，或残了，或者根本就丢失没有了。但是它那两件大罐、高罐，它都带着盖，那是很难得的。
The origin of the 19 pieces of blue and white porcelain is nowhere to be found. The world's third largest collection of Yuan blue and white was discovered in a small town. All this has caused waves of doubt about its authenticity. Is the porcelain genuine or fake? If it's fake, who could be behind this whopping hoax?